In today's video, we are talking about PCOS and symptoms and side effects you might experience. PCOS stands for polycystic ovarian syndrome and affects one out of every 10 women between the ages of 15 and 44. But women who have went through menopause can have it as well. But the thing is, a lot of women do not even know they have it. One study done on over 700 women found that 17% of the women tested had PCOS. However, almost 70% of those women did not know they had it. Women with PCOS have a hard time getting pregnant, they find it difficult to lose weight, and they are at an increased risk of type 2 diabetes and certain types of cancer. While PCOS is becoming more and more common, this doesn't mean it is normal. But there is good news. It can be reversed. But the first step to reversing it is knowing that you have it. So in today's video, I'm going to outline 10 signs and symptoms of polycystic ovarian syndrome, and then we will talk about some steps to reverse it. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high-fat, nutrient-dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. The topic of today is PCOS and signs and symptoms to watch out for. As I mentioned at the start of the video, PCOS is becoming more and more common, but a lot of cases go undiagnosed. And if you do have PCOS, it's really important to know, because not only does it affect your health, but it affects the health of your unborn child as well. 50% of women with PCOS are diagnosed with type 2 diabetes by the time they are 40. They are also 3 times as likely to develop endometrial cancer. And as I already mentioned, it makes it more difficult to get pregnant. Of those women who are able to conceive with PCOS, there is also a greater risk of miscarriages, and it is twice as likely the baby will be delivered prematurely. Now, that all might sound scary, but as I also mentioned before, PCOS can be reversed. To be officially diagnosed, you will have to go see your doctor, but there are a lot of symptoms that are a pretty strong indicator of the syndrome. Of the symptoms, some women will suffer from all of them, and some only a few. And we will get to those symptoms in just a minute, but to be officially diagnosed with PCOS, you have to have 2 out of the 3 following main symptoms: irregular periods, high androgen hormones such as testosterone, and cysts on the ovaries. So as I already said, you do have to go see your doctor to be officially diagnosed, but in this video, I'm going to give you 10 symptoms that are a pretty good indicator. And if you have already been diagnosed with PCOS, make sure to stick around until the end because I'm going to be giving you some tips to reverse it. Number 1, missed periods. Irregular periods are one of the main symptoms, as I already discussed, but it really is the hallmark of PCOS. If you are missing periods or having irregular periods, if your periods are really heavy or really light, this is a pretty good indicator that something's going on, and oftentimes it's PCOS. The missing periods occur because of a hormonal imbalance, starting with insulin levels being too high and affecting other hormones as well. Every month, just before ovulation, there should be a big spike in the hormone estrogen. All estrogen is made from testosterone, but high insulin levels block the ovaries from converting it, and as a result, the spike in estrogen doesn't happen. So you do not ovulate, and you do not have a period. Number 2, acne. Acne is another common symptom, with 1 out of every 3 women with PCOS having it. This side effect stems from the hormonal imbalance again. With more male hormones being produced, the skin becomes oilier and breakouts can happen. These breakouts can occur not only on your face, but on your chest and back as well. Number 3, dark skin patches. As we mentioned before, high insulin is the cause of irregular periods, but it has other side effects as well. One of which being dark patches of skin on skin folds, such as your armpits, neck, and groin. Number 4, excess hair growth. Now this is another really common symptom. Up to 70% of those with PCOS suffer from this. Excess hair can grow in places that it typically wouldn't, on the face, stomach, chest, and back. Again, this comes back to testosterone being too high. Number 5, difficulty losing weight. Up to 80% of women with PCOS are overweight or obese and find it extremely difficult to lose weight. We've mentioned insulin a few times in this video, but I wanted to dive into it further and how it affects weight gain and weight loss. Insulin is known as the fat storage hormone. When we eat, food is broken down into glucose in the bloodstream, and insulin is released. Insulin is responsible for carrying the glucose to our cells. Now, the problem is that when too much insulin is getting pumped out, our cells become insulin resistant. They stop taking in glucose, and insulin levels remain higher than they should for longer periods of time. And remember that insulin is also known as the fat storage hormone, and this is because when insulin levels are high, our bodies are storing fat. Someone with PCOS has high insulin levels almost all the time, and this is why it is so difficult to lose weight. Now, you might be starting to notice a trend here. Insulin is responsible for all of these symptoms, whether directly or indirectly, and that's no coincidence. But we will circle back to this at the end of the video. Number 6, abdominal fat. If you carry a lot of your weight in your midsection, this might be a sign of PCOS. Visceral fat is a type of fat that is stored in the abdomen. It surrounds vital organs, including the liver, stomach, and intestines. Visceral fat is hard, and you will know you have visceral fat if you are not able to pinch it. Now, this type of fat is, once again, caused by high insulin levels. As I mentioned before, if you are insulin resistant, your cells are not responding to insulin properly, and this includes your fat cells, which leads to more fat being stored as visceral fat in the abdomen. Number 7, male pattern baldness. Now, this one is actually a 180 from the excess hair growth that we spoke about earlier, but some women actually experience thinning hair and balding as a result of high testosterone. Number 8, skin tags. Some women with PCOS have tags of skin form on their bodies. These can be found anywhere, but are commonly found in the armpits and around the neck. Number 9, sugar cravings after eating. If you can eat a meal and still be hungry afterwards, this is a pretty strong indicator of insulin resistance and PCOS. High insulin levels mean that your body is not regulating blood sugar properly. The cells in your body are not able to absorb the glucose and use it for energy. So you're eating, and the energy is there, but your body is unable to use it. And this really is a vicious cycle. Number 10, infertility. If you have been trying to get pregnant with no success, PCOS could be the cause. It is the number one cause of infertility, after all. So it is more likely than not you have it if you are unable to get pregnant. So those are the 10 symptoms of PCOS. Now, if you have one or more of those symptoms, you might be feeling pretty discouraged right now. But I promise you, this video does have a happy ending because PCOS can be reversed with diet and lifestyle change. Before I talk about how to reverse PCOS, I want to remind you that to be formally diagnosed, you do need to go see your doctor. And if you tell them you suspect you have PCOS, they will know which tests to run. Reversing PCOS. You might have noticed there was a common theme as we went through this video. It is well known that PCOS is caused by a hormonal imbalance, but what most people focus on is the high testosterone levels. And yes, excess male hormones are what cause a lot of the symptoms, such as excess hair growth and acne. But what causes this rise in testosterone? The answer is insulin, or high insulin levels, to be more specific. The medical term for this is hyperinsulinemia, the presence of an abnormally high concentration of insulin in the blood. As we talked about earlier, in regards to missed periods, it is the hyperinsulinemia that blocks the conversion of testosterone into estrogen and leaves you with high levels of testosterone. So to address PCOS, we need to address hyperinsulinemia. But what causes levels of insulin to be high? I already explained how when we eat, insulin is released in response, but what we eat can make a difference to how much insulin is released. Carbohydrates have the greatest response from insulin. Protein has a moderate response, and fat has almost no response. So by reducing foods that have a high insulin response, less will be produced, and your insulin will remain low. This means focusing on low-carb foods rich in protein and fat, such as eggs, olive oil, and beef. I actually have a free downloadable list that has almost 100 foods with next to no carbohydrates. You can download it by going to my website, healthcoachkate.com/zero carb, and entering in the code word butter in all caps. Focus on these foods and reduce foods high in sugar, grains, and starches, and you will significantly lower your insulin load for the day. The other strategy that is extremely effective for reversing PCOS is intermittent fasting. This means you eat all of your food for the day in a condensed window and spend the rest of your day fasting. One of the most popular variations of this is 16-8. You fast for 16 hours and eat for 8 hours. So if your last meal was at 7 p.m., your first meal the next day would be at 11 a.m. It is very effective for PCOS because when you're not eating, insulin remains low. Intermittent fasting can also help to improve your sensitivity to insulin. So if you do have high carb foods, your body will be able to respond better to them. And finally, you want to build muscle. If you have more muscle mass, your body has more places to store glucose, which can improve insulin sensitivity. And you do not need to kill yourself at the gym either. 10 to 15 minutes of resistance training 3 times a week has been shown to improve insulin sensitivity. Be deliberate with your training. Work hard for short periods of time. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have any of these symptoms and if you have been formally diagnosed with PCOS. Liking and commenting on my videos really helps to support my channel, so even if you just want to say hi, I really appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video, I have another video that goes more into PCOS, what causes it, and just a bit deeper into how to reverse it. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, check them out here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.